Welcome to Space News from the Electric Universe, brought to you by the Thunderbolts Project at thunderbolts.info. Recent episodes of Space News from the Electric Universe have provided a groundbreaking foundation for a new beginning in Earth geology. Thunderbolts contributor Andrew Hall has introduced his hypothesis for the formation of familiar geological features, not from incremental processes over eons of time, but rather due to high-energy electrical discharges in Earth's unique atmosphere. In this episode, Hall concludes his video series with a closer examination of evidence for dramatic electrical scarring of our planet's surface.
In part one of A New Beginning, we introduced evidence of electrohydrodynamic forces that builds mountains in an instant. The evidence is frozen into the shape of the land exactly as it occurred. Let's review. An arcing current creates a shockwave that ablates the land, raising a rooster tail of molten material to form the core of a mountain. The expanding gas and reflected shockwave create an exploding mushroom cloud in its wake. And the updraft it forms provides sustaining energy to the shock envelope by drawing supersonic ground winds through the standing waveform. The supersonic ground winds are channeled by the shock waves to form triangular buttresses. A mountain displays triangular buttresses in a near-perfect mold of the waveform that created it, even displaying complex pressure variations within the waveform. We've seen waveforms that display expansion and contraction, characteristic of superimposed transverse and longitudinal waves. We've seen waveforms that display harmonic repetition caused by shock wave reflection. We've seen how the elasticity of the substrate and the shock wave interact in predictable ways, producing effects that we can analyze, measure, and quantify from the known behavior of shock waves. Now let's look at some electromagnetic effects. The stratified layers of triangular buttresses are often segregated by mineral composition. This is evidence of electromagnetism. An electric field will ionize particles. A magnetic field will sort them. The results can be dramatic. Stratification is evident at all scales, from large-scale landforms to the morphology of the rock itself, right down to the microscopic scale. The shock waves are energized with current. The shock wave is a highly stressed region, a dramatic shear zone of pressure, temperature, and current density. Current coursing through thin shock waves molds the electromagnetic fields in the coherent form of the reflected shock and sorts the material according to its dielectric properties. Arc flash necessarily has a magnetic field surrounding it. Magnetically generated horizontal rotation seems to modify the winds, adding momentum to one side and taking it away on the other, creating asymmetry. Polarization is seen here in this colorized Schlieren photo of a supersonic shockwave. It can produce a mild rotation effect, as seen on this mountain, that displays triangular buttresses on both sides, indicating inflowing winds that meet in the updraft. Or it can form shear winds in opposite directions, leaving buttresses on one side of a narrow ridge. Or it can even scoop a valley within a mountain. One feature that appears often is where an arc contacts ground. The result is a blowout, a crater blasted into the mountain. These features are typically asymmetrical craters with a spillout on one or both sides of the mountain. This mountain has been split in two. It appears in these instances the arc is finding a conductive path beneath the ground, perhaps a mineral deposit or aquifer, and sends a forking tendril to connect with it. More evidence of the electrical arcing that creates the mountains is displayed in an unusual way on Mount Kavoshku in Iran. Here is the result of two arcs interfering with each other. The footprint of Mount Kavoshku is seen in this overhead view as the large symmetric oval to the lower right. The second astrobleem is the smaller kidney-shaped hill connecting with it at the center. both are ringed by blast zones. Here is a closer view. The triangular buttresses can be seen on both sides of the mountain, surrounded by the concentric pressure ridges of the blast zone. This view has been rotated, so the small ridge along the bottom of the frame is the second astrobleme. What's unusual is that the second astrobleme has cut the end off of Mount Kavoshku. The second shockwave sliced the tip of the mountain away. Do you see how the sections have fallen forward like slices of bread? And the second arc deposited an entirely different material between Mount Kavoshku and its head. But the head still displays triangular buttresses from inflowing supersonic winds. The tip of the mountain has been displaced forwards and sideways. But if you piece it back together, it fits nicely. The shock events happened almost simultaneously, which is evident in the pressure wave patterns caused by shear winds between the two blast zones. The stratified layers show the opposing direction of winds meeting at a shear zone, which attests to the fact it was created in a single arc blast event. The land didn't split apart to separate the mountain. Two forks of an arc reclosed, and one shockwave sliced the other apart. Large mountains are also built the same way. Now that you recognize triangular buttresses as shockwave forms, let's look at what the rooster tail can do. You will recall the rooster tail is like what you see behind a speedboat, something like this. This is the Mount Fitzroy group in Patagonia, at the southern end of the Andes on the Argentine-Chilean border. The clean granite faces are a famous challenge to big wall mountain climbers. You can see why. You can also see how the rock is layered almost vertically at one orientation in the core and another orientation on the flanks. Its height is a little over 11,000 feet. The core of the mountain has been sucked up into a series of narrow shards by the rooster tail of an extremely powerful shockwave, created by an atmospheric arcing current. Its flanking ridges are layered onto the core, welded in parallel stratified layers, perpendicular to the wind that made them, oriented radially towards the core. And triangular buttresses show their consistent angles of reflection on the western flanks. Here, the sun catches the larger triangular features well in this view. Of course, other big mountains were made this way too. I can't think of the name of any right now, but we'll find some new case studies soon. There is a great deal more to be said about the electric Earth. You're watching the results of new research as it unfolds. Arcs in the atmosphere, blistering mountains with arc blast, is not all there is to the form of the Earth. However, there have been 10 visually evident similarities presented between mountain forms and shock waves. Skeptics like to say extraordinary claims require extraordinary proof. For mountains to display the exact features of shockwaves, including repeating reflected standing waveforms, superposition transverse and longitudinal wave expansion and compression, harmonic reflection, wind and shock-oriented stratification, pressure ridges, normal shocks, waveform compression and cancellation, waveform instability, expansion fans and boundary effects, all of which collectively point to a single coherent shock event as their origin, begs for a coherent explanation. No uniformitarian theory provides that. The arc blast model does. Others with perspectives and skills that complement mine are involved. As we gather and prepare new evidence for presentation, please stay tuned. Thank you.
For continuous updates on space news from the Electric Universe, stay tuned to thunderbolts.info.